My secret ingredient makes this the best gluten-free spaghetti and meatballs you could ever imagine. First, I'm gonna start with some onion. I'm gonna start building the meatballs. I'm gonna grate this onion on a box grater so that that way it will blend seamlessly into the meatballs and you don't have to pre-cook it. I don't wanna squeeze out all the moisture. I want some of that, but I just want the paper towel to absorb a little bit of the moisture. And now it's time for my secret ingredient. I'm using instant potato flakes, which are incredible. They are naturally gluten-free because they're just made from potatoes. Just a quarter cup of heavy cream. Now I'm gonna add just a little bit of Parmesan cheese. This is Parm Reg. It's gonna add sort of that nutty, savory, salty goodness to the meatballs. I have some chopped fresh oregano. Add some salt, of course, and pepper. Two eggs. And last, I have three garlic cloves grated on a microplane because it turns it into garlic pulp in no time. I'm just trying to mash out any of the big lumps in the potatoes. So the meat I have is a combination of ground pork and ground beef, and I'm just gonna get in here with my hands because that's the best way to mix. If you have kids, kids love getting in and helping with this. So what I'm doing is I'm patting the mixture down into the bowl. I want 32 meatballs. So the way I do that is just to make quadrants here, section it out into quarters, and I know that each quarter should make about 8 meatballs. Divide it in half, this should make 4 meatballs. Then I divide that roughly in half, and then I know this should make 2 meatballs. They're not gonna be perfect, but that's the beauty of home cooking. These are going to bake at 425 degrees for about 15 minutes. To build the sauce, I'm gonna start with some olive oil, chili flakes or crushed red pepper, some garlic cloves that I've thinly sliced. Those flavors are just gonna bloom in the olive oil. I have the heat on fairly low. I don't want to burn the garlic, but I do want it to start getting a little bit of color on it. Now I'm going to stir in a little bit of tomato paste. This will thicken the sauce. I'm going to add tomatoes. I have two large cans of San Marzanos. These are whole tomatoes, so we need to break up the tomatoes, and I always just do it with my hands. The noises are pretty great. It may sound corny, but if I'm putting my hands in the food, I feel like I'm putting myself into the meal. And it's just that much more an expression of love. Oh, these are done and they look great. They're nice and brown and they smell so meaty. Okay, and now the last part of the sauce is the seasoning. So I definitely want some salt. I have the red pepper in here, so I'm not gonna add any black pepper. Oregano sprigs, basil sprigs, and then a bay leaf. Okay, I'll bring that up to a boil and then lower it to a simmer and let all the flavors kind of come together for just like 10 or 15 minutes. Gluten-free pasta has certainly come a long way. You would not be able to tell from the taste or the texture that it's gluten-free. So just cook it like you would any pasta. Large pot of water, plenty of water. Big pot of yummy goodness here. Let me go ahead and dish up a serving here so you can see how great this looks. Gotta make sure everybody has 4 meatballs. If they don't, there will be a fight. I'm just going to garnish each serving with more of that beautiful Parm Reg and then some fresh basil. That is gluten-free spaghetti and meatballs. I'm so excited to dig into this. So good. The meatball is really garlicky in a great way. All the flavors are just so beautiful. It is such a comforting bowl of food, whether you're gluten-free or not.